How I rejoiced when I heard them say, let's go up to God's house today. Here we are in Jerusalem, city of the living God. Enter his courts with songs of praise, enter his gates with thanks. He is the Lord, he is our God, honor and bless his name. How I rejoiced when I heard them say, let's go up to God's house today. Here we are in Jerusalem, city of the living God.
This mass is offered for the following intentions: birthday blessings of Ria Criado, Fridella Paz da Silva, Ona Fix, Margaret Pinto, Shirley Albuquerque, Adrian da Silva. Wedding anniversary blessings for Neves and Trevor Castellino, Sean and Arpana Fernandez. Good health and well-being of John Philip, souls of Sebastian and Anna Clara Lopez, Sarah Briganza, Filomena and Paul Crasto, Jose and Silvestrina Dias, Francis Vesauker, Raymond D'Souza, Brendan Fernandez, Kingsley Barrow, deceased members of Roderick's family, Joseph Augustine De Cruz, Joseph and Wilma Saldana, Gaspar Saldana, Antoinette Pinto, William and Kathleen Martis. We also pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays and anniversaries today. All together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, at this Eucharist, we ask Jesus to help us to grow in humility. Celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner. Let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Romans. I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means. For I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham and a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people whom he knew. So I ask, did they stumble in order that they might fall? By no means. Rather, through their trespass, salvation has come to the Gentiles so as to make Israel jealous. Now, if their trespass means riches for the poor, for the world, and if their failure means riches for the Gentiles, how much more will their full inclusion mean? Lest you be wise in your own sight, I do not want you to be unaware of this mystery, brothers. A partial hardening has come upon Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles has come in. And in this way, all Israel will be saved. As it is written, the deliverer will come from Zion. He will banish ungodliness from Jacob. And this will be my covenant with them when I take away their sins. As regards the gospel, they are enemies for your sake. But as regards election, they are beloved for the sake of their forefathers. For the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, the Lord will not abandon his people. Kindly listen to the tune.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
Altogether.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
Blessed the man whom you discipline, O Lord, whom you train by means of your law, to whom you give peace in evil days. Together.
The Lord will not abandon his people.
The Lord will not abandon his people, nor forsake those who are his heritage. For judgment shall again be just, and all true hearts shall uphold it. Together.
The Lord will not abandon his people. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
All together.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Take my yoke upon you, says the Lord, and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to
you. Glory to you, O Lord.
One Sabbath when Jesus went to dine at the house of a ruler of the Pharisees, they were watching him carefully. Now he told the parable to those who were invited. When he noticed how they chose the places of honor, saying to them, when you are invited by someone to a wedding feast, do not sit down in a place of honor, lest someone more distinguished than you be invited by him, and he who invited you both will come and say to you, give your place to this person, and then you will begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit in the lowest place, so that when your host comes, he may say to you, friend, move up higher. Then you will be honored in the presence of all who sit at table with you. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel passage of today reminds us of the need of true humility and generous sharing with the needy. True humility, dear brothers and sisters, is the personal responsibility of every authentic Christian. It is through humility that it is the doorway or the pathway of reaching out to the others, very especially to the poor and the needy. The gospel passage warns us of pride and also the attitude of overestimating or underestimating our worth. Let us pray, my dear brothers and sisters, at this Eucharist, that we may continue to stay rooted and grounded in humility. Amen.
Lord, accept this bread and wine. Take our hearts and make them thine. Take our worth and our anxiety. Give us life and liberty. Change this bread into Christ's body, and this wine into His blood. Change our lives, make us united, Lord, to spread Your love, Your peace, Your joy.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands in the praise and glory of His name for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your Majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Made holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our act of spiritual communion, my Jesus,
I believe
that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things,
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment
since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you were already there
and unite myself
holy to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen. Whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers, that you do unto me. Whatsoever you do to the least of my sisters, that you do unto me. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me to drink. Now enter into the home of my Father. Whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers, that you do unto me. Whatsoever you do to the least of my sisters, that you do unto me.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us save us from the virus. Abba Father, have mercy on us, save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion.
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs may one day possess in truth. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us. The Mass is ended. Go forth in peace. We share the good news we have received and live each moment in Christ our Lord, so that our actions give praise to God. Thank you for planting your holy word deep in our hearts, Lord. A two-edged sword, the bread was broken, we learn to share with one another, help us to care.